Hey everybody, I'm Nick Pomisciano, and I'm really excited to show you this film that Tim O'Donnell and I made last year about the Fort Bragg Combatives Tournament. Over the last year, we've done a lot with this film, including enter it into the GI Film Festival, where it received a lot of acclaim. And we've actually been in a position where we've been offered money from several different organizations for ownership of this film so they could show it in their own networks. However, after discussion, we felt like this film belonged with you, the veteran community. This film shows how important Army Combatives is to the individual and also to the Army. It's the essence of the warrior spirit. If you like this film, I really hope that you share it online, through social media, however you can, because we believe it tells an amazing story about the American warrior class.
The Combatives Tournament, to me, is the pinnacle of being a warrior. It demonstrates all the different aspects that prove somebody to be a warrior.
Well, since 2005, the Army's hosted the Army Championship event in Combatives. This year is the first year, for various reasons, that they were unable to do that. We want to give the soldiers the opportunity to still compete in 2013 to be champions. And right now we have about 14 teams from outside of Fort Bragg, 54 teams total, just under 300 competitors, and it's going to be a great event.
Keep going, Maurer. Good job. Hold it. You're good. Keep going. Hey, free up some air. Grab an arm.
I was a three-time All-Army Combatives Champion at 205 pounds. Fought, I don't even know, 15 fights over the course of those three different Combatives tournaments. I've accomplished a lot of things in my MMA career, fighting for the UFC, winning my debuts, first-round knockouts, main event. But truthfully, being an Army Combatives Champion is the biggest accomplishment of my career.
Now what we're gonna do is just gonna sit off to the side and grab the leg. When you get here, you start walking towards his head, looking to sink or carry or grab or hold the leg.
Combatives is a core fundamental for all warriors. I think every single warrior should absolutely be trained and honed in combatives.
You know, combatives builds the total warrior concept. We train specifically on using our weapons for far distance engagement, a variety of weapon systems. But inside that range, 2 meters and less, you have to use your mind and your body. And that's what combatives teaches, is that the willingness to close with your enemy and to bring your fight to your opponent.
Ready? Fight!
Graduated West Point in 2006, where I wrestled. I competed all 4 years. And in 2006, I was commissioned in the infantry and went to Ranger School and then to my unit in Fort Lewis, 123 Infantry. I was a platoon leader and executive officer with them.
Go back to the 5 second game
square. Deployed to Iraq 2009 to 10. And then I went to Fort Benning and was a company commander.
Hey, winner by points.
Towards the tail end of my command, I started training for Greco-Roman wrestling, and then eventually made it out to Fort Carson, Colorado, made the world-class athlete program, placed third in the Olympic trials, made national team, and my next goal is to go back to the world-class athlete program and win a gold medal in the 2016 Olympics Greco-Roman wrestling.
My first wrestling match I lost, the very first one I stepped on the mat, and to deal with that defeat, that inner defeat, you know, there's no one to blame. There's no one to, hey, man, why didn't you help out? It's all on the inside. And it's just unique, man. It's challenging, and there's nothing like it. I love that inner fight, that constant struggle, man.
I'm Staff Sergeant Josh McLean, right? Been in the Army for about 9 years right now. Started off in the 82nd as a medic. And it is a little different. You know, I've competed on the civilian side and with soldiers, and I think the big difference is that we all know that this is for a purpose, all right? It's not just a sport. Of course, it is a sport and it's fun, but at the end of the day, these are all life-saving skills, all right? There's not a point system on the battlefield. That's the bottom line, all right? It doesn't matter if the guy had you mounted and was freaking you know, on top of you doing damage to you, you gotta get off your back. You gotta get to a position that's gonna save your life or set your buddy up to come save your life. You know, at that point in my life, I kind of had to make a decision. Was I did get a little D2 offer to go wrestle in college in Chicago. But at the same time, all the Iraq stuff was unfolding, and, you know, I kind of had to make that decision. What am I going to do? And ultimately, obviously, I went with, you know, going into the service. So, you know, joined, went to the 82nd, went to combat right away, did a 15-month tour over there.
Push on the back of the head, John. Hey, get that air. You got that control knocking outside. Roll into him. There you go.
There you go.
Good job.
Went, did another 9-month trip to Afghanistan, and when I came back, they offered me this job to be the combatives instructor for third group, and I jumped all over it, brother. So this last year has been phenomenal. I've learned so much, and just to get to be around some of these guys is just an awesome experience.
Push away.
From the instructor side now, I see there's a bigger picture here as far as what combatives does. And to see some of these soldiers come in so timid and not familiar with their body, that's scary to me that you would send someone like that to combat that's never been hit or put in a spot where they gotta really, you know, deal with that huge adrenaline dump.
The worst situation in the world for someone to experience an adrenaline dump for the first time is in war. A bullet snaps by their head, they start freaking out. Adrenaline gets produced, and then they crash. That's not when it has to happen for the first time. It has to happen in training. And the only time that you can really create that is through combatives, where they're scared that they're gonna get choked out, that they're gonna get tapped out. The only way that we can create that physiological response is through combatives.
There's very little training in the Army where you get to try to harness your adrenaline, to control your adrenaline. And the only other two training is jumping and fast roping. Other than that, it's combatives. I feel the same way before I go on a match, about right before I'm about to jump out of an airplane.
The difference between the average and the above average competitor soldier is focus. I have a specific routine that I use. I start from a broad focus, taking in the energy of the crowd, and I narrow it in into what's important in the moment. I call it what's important now, WIN, a little acronym that helps me focus into the moment. So as I get closer and performance is imminent, I focus on what's important now. And then by the time I step onto the mat, I switch phases into execution, and I'm thinking about one thing, and that's position, or depending on the situation, it could be grips. But I focus my attention on one thing, and that way my performance is automatic, and I don't have to think about anything else.
I haven't changed too much from my warm-up from wrestling. I think everyone's got their little things that they have to do to get their mind right, but I kind of have to separate myself from everything, and really I have to get a good sweat going, and I just try to visualize what I'm gonna accomplish in that next match.
I love fighting. I love everything about fighting. I love the pain that you have to go through and endure during the preparation for a fight. And then the experience of walking into the cage, knowing that you've done everything right, all your blood, sweat, and tears, being away from your family, starving yourself, cutting weight, for that moment to go in there, the opportunity, not for the glory, but to demonstrate that you're the best at what you do that night.
So for the first time, we have colonels and senior leaders from other posts pitted against each other in these finals matches, both utilizing standard and advanced rules.
I think it's going to be awesome for soldiers to see, like, their chain of command go at it, and they're just like the rest of us.
We have too many senior leaders that don't lead by example, and what better way to do it than step in the mat and, you know, put it all on the line. It's warrior ethos. It's Fort Bragg. It's the essence of being a paratrooper in the 82nd Airborne Division or 18th Airborne Corps, and it's leadership by example. Should be part of the prerequisite for training.
So we have the Division IG Colonel and the 18th Airborne Colonel from G3 fighting in the cage against each other. What is more powerful in front of your peers and subordinates in an uncomfortable position and compete? It is absolutely what it is to be a leader in the Army.
Fighting in front of my brothers in arms, it means a lot. I have a lot of pride. I try to represent the blood that was shed and the sacrifices that were made as best as possible. To be out there and to be able to represent them under the spotlight, it's an honor.
To be honest, this is going to be my first time to get into an actual cage and duke it out. You know, although I've trained day in and day out for the cage with all my buddies that have had lots of experience, this is going to be my first time stepping into it.
He's a real competitor, and that's what true competition is all about. You want the best guy out there. You want to go toe-to-toe. He's long. He has good striking from what I hear. Has a good wrestling base, and he's in great shape. Happens to be all my strengths as well, so it's going to be fun.
He's a little bit shorter, and he's going to have to deal with my reach. So I have my game plan. I'm going to try to stick to it to the best of my ability. I'm going to give him a big, stiff jab, and he's going to have to work around that. And, you know, this should be fireworks, man. We'll see where it goes.
In my opinion, both of those guys, not only are they world-class athletes, but they're vicious fighters. They're violent, and they're very talented, and they have a passion for combatives. The contrast in their styles is also one of those stylistic matchups that can create the perfect and best fight. The grappler versus striker. The striker has good takedown defense. And the chemistry that's there, both of them are explosive. Both of them can finish a fight in a bunch of different ways. It creates tension in the cage that everyone will feel. I'm excited for that fight for a lot of different reasons. You know, it's going to be a great fight. Things I've learned about myself from fighting are that I'm not perfect, that I can be broken, that I have to train to be strong, that if I don't train, I could die, I could lose, and I have lost because of that. I learned about everything I needed to know about myself solely from fighting. I could go story after story after story, both in Iraq and Afghanistan, where if I wasn't who I was and I didn't know what I know, it would have become a lethal situation. Combatives is important to me. It saved my life. It saved civilians' life. It saved combatants' lives.
And the